Thank you. The next item of business is consideration of motion 447 in the name of John Swinney on treating the Coronavirus Extension and Expiry Scotland Bill as an emergency bill. And any member who wishes to speak against the motion should press their request to speak button now. And I call on George Adam to speak to and move the motion.
Can I move the motion and speak to the motion as well, Presiding Officer? Basically, over the past, as you'll agree, over the past number of weeks, I've tried to be reasonable in my work that I've done with colleagues on the Bureau, but sometimes reason can only be one-sided. But as I've previously explained to other members of the Bureau, the Coronavirus Extension Expiry Scotland Bill was introduced on the 18th of June, and having a stage a day from the 22nd to the 24th of June to maximise scrutiny time. This obviously is a change from the previous versions of the bill previously, where it was done over one day. Now, that would mean stage one would be today, stage two tomorrow, and stage three Thursday. In order to create further flexibility, the Bureau agreed to 6:30 decision times on both Tuesdays, Wednesdays and Thursdays. And I believe the passage of this bill is not too difficult for those to understand. If we do not pass the bill before summer recess, there will be significant less time for citizens and public authorities will have significant less time to respond to the changes before they come into effect at September. Also, if we take into account the time needed for royal assent, if the bill is not introduced and passed by the end of June, we run the very serious risks of the provisions expiring on the 30th of September and temporary measures which are enabling public authorities to continue to operate in the pandemic falling away.
Colleagues, we will hear the Minister. Thank you.
As I have said countless times previously, this bill does not introduce any new provisions. It merely removes temporary measures that are no longer necessary or extends the expiry date to March 2022 to ensure that public bodies can continue to operate while public health measures remain in place. Officials have engaged with stakeholders in the ongoing use of the temporary measures throughout the reporting periods. And they have also engaged on an informal basis with stakeholders when considering when temporary measures should be extended or expired. Presiding Officer, I think it is obviously clear why we must progress with this bill this week. To leave everything else to chance, as others would propose, would not be a prudent way forward. So I put the motion forward to the Chamber.
Thank you. I call on Stephen Kerr.
Presiding Officer, this bill should not be treated as an emergency bill. Emergency implies that we need a sense of urgency, and to go against established processes of consultation and parliamentary scrutiny. However, we do not have such a sense of urgency, as the powers granted by the Coronavirus Scotland Act do not run out until the 30th of September 2021. So instead of steamrolling through this bill in a few short hours over the next 3 days, the government should use the summer recess to consult more widely on the proposed extension to the emergency provisions. The summer recess should also be used to see how COVID develops. Thanks to the UK government's vaccine procurement and the tireless work of NHS staff and volunteers throughout the UK, more people are developing immunity each day. All the data is telling us that the vaccines are highly effective against all the known variants. In the weeks and months ahead, the rate of immunity will continue to increase as the vaccine is continued to be rolled out at an accelerated rate of progress. This will hopefully see the rate of transmission and the number of people requiring hospitalisation decline. If it does, then the situation we are in as we return from recess will be more optimistic, as these powers will run on until at least March 2022. It would only be appropriate for this Parliament to debate and vote on an extension of these emergency powers after the government has held a proper consultation and we have seen the impact of the continued vaccination rollout over the summer.
Thank you. I call Alex Cole-Hamilton. Briefly, please.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. It will be brief. I had not intended to rise in this debate, but as the Minister wouldn't take my intervention, I feel compelled to speak now. This is a piece of legislation that empowers the executive of branch of government, once again, to an unprecedented level. But we are asked, as a legislature, to pass this bill in 3 days for a landscape of the virus that we won't understand for many weeks to come. We're asking to empower, being asked to empower this government with a set of powers that will come into force towards the end of this year and then turn into the next year. This is a level of power that in any other circumstance no other party in this parliament would endorse or support, and as such I cannot support the timetabling of this bill as it stands.
Thank you. I call on the Minister to respond.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. As I have said to the members previously, we have tried to be reasonable in putting this forward. We still live in extremely difficult times. There is still a pandemic happening in Scotland as we speak. To not actually have these powers in place at this stage would actually put things at risk, and would actually, the idea of putting your hands in your pockets and looking to see what happens over the next couple of months is not a way forward as far as I'm concerned. So, in closing, Presiding Officer, I would say that we need to go through with, as we've said, over the next 3 days. There is opportunity for those to actually involve in the process and to ensure that we can make sure that we have the bill that we all want to put forward.
Thank you. The question is that motion 447, in the name of John Swinney, on the Coronavirus Extension and Expiry Scotland Bill, be agreed. Are we all agreed?
Yes.
The Parliament is not agreed, therefore we will move to a vote. We'll have a short technical suspension.